ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। नमस्कार, स्वागतम्। वेलकम फ्रेंड्स टू दि पंचतंत्र क्लास। Day before yesterday we had actually started with a new story, fifth story in the first Tantra, Mitra Bheda, and the story's name is Mithya Vishnu Kaulika Katha. A Kaulika weaver falling at the first sight in love with a princess, and thereby what happened to the weaver we have all seen, how he fell to the ground and then he was he immediately went into swoon. He was helped out by his friends in transporting him to the house of his friend Ratakara, and then with advice of the doctors and the mantrikas he was made to be conscious. And once he became conscious, we came to know that and the friend asked him, his bosom friend, best friend, the Ratakara, asked him as to what exactly happened to him, why did he fall to the temple in the procession. To that the friend gives a very lengthy answer, and when on pressing, the weaver reveals the secret of his sickness, rather we say, and secret of his falling to the ground. And then he says that the moment he saw the princess at the in the procession, during the procession at the temple, he had fallen in love, and he imagines to be enjoying the company of that princess, and which is not possible according to him, and therefore he wants to die, and he wants his friend's Ratakara's carpenter's help in order to achieve that not achieve the goal, but he wants him to relieve him from the pangs of love by dying, and therefore he asks him to prepare for the funeral, the pyre, arrange for the pyre. So the friend says, after listening to the secret of his problem, the Ratakara says, this is nothing, in a today itself you will be able to enjoy the princess. And with his dexterity, with his skill, he manages to prepare with using his skill of carpentry, chariot, and he also decorates his friend like Vishnu, and beautifies him with all the Vishnu's paraphernalia. And then he asks he shows the mechanism to fly the chariot and go over to the princess, who lives on the seventh floor of the building, royal palace, which is not accessible otherwise. Even air cannot escape there, so much security. In spite of so much security, the carpenter asks his friend to fly with his newly made machine and go over and pose himself as Vishnu and cheat the innocent princess and make love with her. That is what has happened. So, Sapta Bhumika, I have told everything in English, now let us move ahead. Start.
Page number 109,
sir. Yeah.
We have to start from the beginning.
Yes, yes.
Kaulikopi tad akarniya tatharupastatra gatva tam aha. He rajaputi sukta kimva jagarshi aham tavakute samudrat samurabho lakshmin vihayai vahagataha.
Kaulikopi, on being told by Ratakara, the carpenter, Kaulika must have taken the machine, the flying machine, wooden flying machine, and then he has supposed to have gone to the seventh floor where the princess is staying. Kaulikopi tad akarnya. Tad akarnya means having heard his friend's words. Tatha Rupaha, there is some blurring in the text, Srinivas. Is it clear in your book?
Yeah, it is clear.
No, Tatharupastatra is clear?
Yes.
Okay. Tatharupaha, tadakarnya, having heard his friend's words, tatharupaha, tadrusharupaha. Tatha means in the same form, Vishnu rupaha iti. Tatharupaha, tatra, gatva, tatra, sapta, earlier, sapta bhumika prasadam prati, gatva, having gone there to the seventh floor, tam aha, tam rajakumarim uddishya aha avadat evam. He said like this, hey Rajaputri, supta kimva jagarshi. Look at the very first encounter of this Kaulika, the Tantuvayaha, otherwise you can say Tantravayaha or Tantuvayaha. Kaulika is explained as kulam sutradikam vayati iti. Kulam nama sutram. Sutra adikam vayati is a weaver. So, supta kimva jagarshi? What a direct question. Rude way of speaking, you see. Supta kimva jagarshi? Are you asleep or awake? Tvam supta siva jagarshiva. Aham tava krute samudrat sanuragaha lakshmim vihaya. Iha eva agata. How do you break here? Vihaya plus eva agata. Vihaya eva agata. Vriddhi sandhi. So what is saying? Aham tava krute, for your sake. Krute iti avyepadam. Shasti prayoga. Tava krute samudrat, from the ocean. Sanuraga with love. I have come here with all the love from the ocean. Kshirasagara, Lakshmim vihaya, leaving my wife Lakshmi, as if he is Vishnu now. Now we are also given to understand, he is to pose himself as a Vishnu. So he is talking like a Vishnu. Hey, are you sleeping or awake? I have come all the way from my ocean, leaving my wife Lakshmi, because of love for you. Sanuragaha Lakshmim vihaya eva agataha tat kriyatam maya saha. Samagamaha iti. So, samagamaha means sexual enjoyment. Now, come on, and what is the, see the direct rude way of this fellow's behavior, shows his character also. Tat, therefore, kriyatam, let it be done, maya saha, along with me, samagamaha. Come on, let you enjoy with me. That is what he said.
Sati.
Now, this is karmani lot. Samagamaha kriyatam. Samagamaha kriyatam kena saha maya saha along with me.
Sapi varudharudham chaturbhujam sayudham kaustubhopetam kaustubhopetam avalokya sadismaya shayanaduthaya provacha he bhagavan aham manushi kitika ashuchihi bhagavan Bhagavan Strailokya Pavano Mandaniyascha Tat Kathameta Ujjyate
Sapi, Sapi, Sanama Atra Rajakumari Api Rajakanya Api Garuda Arudham. She was startled to see a person mounted on Garuda. Garuda Arudham. Garude Arudham. Chaturbhujam. Having four arms, sayudham, all ayudhas were fixed by his friend carpenter. Sayudham, kaustubha upetam, kaustubhena kaustubha manina upetam. And there was some artificial kaustubha like also studded there. Kaustubho upetam avalokya drushtva, seeing all these marks of Vishnu, savismaya, vismayena sahita, with wonderstruck, Shayanat Uthaya, she got up from her bed. Shayanat Uthaya Lebanta, Pra Uvacha Provacha, she said like, hey Bhagavan, Aham Manushi, Kitika Ashuchihi. She, this innocent, that is why friend said, she is very innocent. That is the word, what is the word was used there? Kanya Mugda. Mugdha Svabhavam, in the earlier statement of the friend, Mugdha Svabhavam, Sarla Svabhavam, that innocent girl, she says, hey Bhagavan, O Lord, aham manushi, I am just a ordinary human being. Kidika, I am just a human worm. I am like a worm, ashuchi, impure. I am a human being like a worm, very impure, ashuchihi. Bhagavan Trailokya, Bhagavan and your Lord Trailokya Pavanaha. You are the most pure in all the three worlds. Vandaniyascha, and you are all respectable. Tat, therefore, katham, how come etad yujyati, how is this possible? How can I enjoy with you? You are God. Compared to you, I am an ordinary human being like a worm, very impure, and you are the most respected in the worlds. How can I enjoy with you? How is this possible? So, katham etad yujyati, how is this proper yujyati? Samanja Sambandh, Lokalika.
Kaulika Raha, Ke Subhagi, Satya Vabhihitam Bhavatya. Kintu, Radha Namni Me Bharya, Gopa Kula Prasuta, Prathamam Asit, Sa Tvamatravatirna, Tenaha Matrayata.
Okay, can father. Kaulika Raha, the Kaulika, the weaver said, Subhage, Subhage, oh lovely, charming, fortunate woman. Bhagam means fortune, Bhagam also means beauty. Hey Subhage, oh lovely, beautiful lady. Satyam abhihitam, abhihitam uktam. Satyam abhihitam uktam bhavatya. Now here he has used the respectful pronoun bhavati shabda. Toya is not used. Earlier he said very rashly. The previous dialogue is very harsh. Tvam used. Yushma Chabda. Satyam abhitam bhavatya kintu. What you said is true. Kintu. Radha namni me bharya gopakula prasuta prathama asit. First, I had one wife by name Radha who was born in Gopakula. Prathama asit. She was my first wife. First there. Satvam atra avatina. The same Radha, you are now born here. He is fooling her. Satvam atra asmin raja vamshe avatirna utpanna iti. You are born here in this family. Tena therefore aham atra ayataha. Tena tat karanat tena karanena aham Vishnuhu atra ayataha agataha agatavan agacham. So that innocent girl now thinks that she must have been Radha in her previous life.
Incarnation of
Radha. Yes, incarnation of Radha. Iti ukta.
Iti ukta saam praha te bhagavan yadi evam tanme tatam prakthaya sopi avikalpum maam tubhyam prayachcha.
Very innocently, very straightforwardly, very decent behavior of the girl is shown here. Iti ukta, thus told by the fake Vishnu, sa praha, she said, Bhagavan, yadi evam, if so, if what you say is correct that I was Radha in the previous life and born here, tat then me tatam prarthaya, mama tatam, mama pitaram prarthaya. You go and request my father. As a very noble gesture, this girl said, saha api avikalpam avishankam nishankam nishankochena. Avikalpam means without any vikalpa, doubt. Without any doubt, he will maam tubhyam prayachati. Maam tubhyam prayachati. He will offer me to you. So please go and tell my father. Now here, how does, see the cleverness of this cunning, uncultured Kaulika. You see the next dialogue. Kaulika aha.
Kaulika aha, e subhage, na aham darshana patham manushanam gacchami, kim unaranapakaranam, tvam gandharvena vivahena atmanam prayaccha. Noche chapam dattva sanvayam te itaram bhasmasat karishyami.
Which God will say like this? He is forcing her to enjoy with him. Otherwise he says, I will make your father and family reduce them to basmasat karishyami, I will reduce them to ashes. Hey, then Kaulika said, hey Subhage, naham darshanapatam. Look at the answer giving. You go and mama tatam, tata, what he said? Me tatam, mama tatam prarthaya. She said, gachad, bhavan gachadu mama tatam prarthayatu, pitaram prarthayatu, samam tubhyam prayachati. She says, na aham darshanapatam manushanam gachami. I don't come to be seen by human beings. I am a Vishnu. Naham prakashah sarvasya yogamaya samavrutaha iti Gita pravada. So that is what he is saying. Maybe Vishnusharma, when he was writing these dialogues, he had that is in mind, Gita. Naham prakashah sarvasya, I am not visible to everybody. Why so? Yogamaya samavrutaha. So in the same way, na aham darshanapatam manushanam gachami, I don't become visible to human beings. Kim punaha, then what to say more, punaha alapanam, alapakaranam, then where is the question of talking? When I don't, when I can't be seen by human beings, where is the question of talking to your father? David, is that is what he says. Tvam gandharvena vivahena atmanam prayaccha. Now he says, you, now this is a kind of, you know, Srinivas, Gandharva Vivaha is one of the Ashtavida Vivahas explained in our Manusmriti, in our law, Hindu law. And this is the sixth type of the marriage, you know. Gandharva Vivaha is the sixth type explained among the eight types. Gandharva Vivaha says, there is one quotation, you know, Paraspara Mito, Srinivas, Mitaha Anugamat or something. Mutual consent is there. You know, Gandharva Vivaha means where both agree to get married without the permission of the parents, either of the parents. They don't need. Like this is exactly what is the, what can be called in the modern day is love marriage, Srinivas. Gandharva Vivaha is love marriage. Now I tell you, since the occasion demands, let us recall the Ashtavida Vivahas. The first Vivaha is called Brahmaha. Brahmaha Vivaha, the first of the, among the eight list, where the, there is a karika also, bride is given, offered, bride, the vadhu is offered to the vara with all the bhushana, decoration. Vadhu is well decorated and offered to the vara. That is called Brahmaha Vivaha. It is adjectival to Vivaha Shabda, Pullinga. Brahmaha Vivaha. Where Vadhu is fully decorated and offered to the Vadhu, vara. This is the one type. Then we move on to Daivaha Vivaha. Daivaha, second one is called Daivaha. Daiva Vivaha is that Vivaha where the Vadhu, the daughter, is offered at the end of the sacrifice to the sacrificing priest. Yagna is performed. Yagnante Purohitaya Kanya Diyati. So, Daivaha marriage is that marriage wherein the girl, daughter is given at the end of the sacrifice to the priest. Which priest? Who has performed the yajna? Officiating priest only. That is Daivaha. The third is called Arshaha Vivaha. In this form of Arsha Vivaha, the father of the bride receives, Kanya Pita, receives either one or two pairs of cows from the vara. It's a kind of shulka in the form of godhana. The father of the girl receives either one or two pairs of cows from the vara in the Arsha type of Vivaha. Then the we come to the fourth, Prajapatyaha Vivaha. Prajapatyaha. In this form, Prajapatya, the Vadhu, the daughter is given to the Vara without expecting or taking anything from his side. Without giving also. No giving, no taking. And with a blessing that you both live happily with all full trust. That is called Prajapatya. The idea is that I don't give, I don't take here in Prajapatya, but you both live happily. Blessings are there for the couple in this Prajapatya. How many are over?
Four.
Then the fifth is Asuraha Vivaha. Asuraha. Asura Vivaha is where the Vadhu is purchased, the bride is purchased by the Vara. He gives an amount and then purchases the Vadhu. Asura Vivaha. That means the Kanya Pita takes money and gives his daughter to the Vara. That is Asura Vivaha. Then comes this reference, our Gandharvena Vivahena, here in Panchatantra we have. Sixth Vivaha is called Gandharvaha Vivaha. This is that type where without any witnesses, without taking permission from the parents, they get married. Only Daiva is Sakshi. No human Sakshi will be there. So it is equivalent to our love marriage nowadays. Mutually they agree to get married. But now that is also I am finding fault here. Gandharvena Vivahena Atmanam Prayacha. He is forcing this girl to offer herself Gandharva Vivaha. This is a kind of Paishacha Vivaha otherwise. It comes under Paishacha. I will tell you what is Paishacha now. Then comes Gandharva over, seventh, Rakshasa Vivaha. Rakshasaha Vivaha. Like in this, the Vara comes and takes by force the Vadhu. Like Sri Krishna taking Satyabhama by force, defeating all this. So that is Rakshasa Vivaha. In Rakshasa Vivaha, what happens? The Vara comes and by force, he takes away the Vadhu and whoever opposes him, he defeats them in the battle. Defeating the people, opposing people in the battle. That is called Rakshasa Vivaha. And the Adhamadama Vivaha is the last one. Paishachaha. The eighth one is Paishachaha. In this, the Vara or the lover carries away the Vadhu and by force he enjoys her without her consent. So there is one beautiful quotation also. Suptam mattam pramattam va raho yatropagacchati papishto vivahanam paishachaha. Papisto vivahanam paishachaha, it is said. The most heinous papista vivaha is paishacha because suptam, the fellow comes here, lover, takes the sleeping girl, suptam, mattam, intoxicated girl, pramattam, mentally deranged girl. He comes to take either a sleeping girl or an intoxicated girl or mentally deranged girl. And then he has the by force he tries to enjoy her. This is called papista. Papisto vivahanam paishachaha astamo smrutaha. So that is what. But there, this is not pure Gandharva here. Coming back to our room.
Yeah.
He is asking her. Forcing her, not asking, forcing her. Tvam Gandharvena Vivahena Atmanam Prayacha. You offer yourself to me in the form of Gandharvivaha. No chet, now this is threatening. No chet, if otherwise, avyaya. Syapam dattva sanvayam te pitaram sa anvayam sa kulam. Kulanvitam, with your, you and your father's family, full anvayam. kim karishyami bhasmasat karishyami, I will reduce your father and his entire family to ashes. Now you know, when any nice girl, I mean girl of a good family, is threatened, told that your father will be, she immediately becomes, she yields herself, because every kulavadhu loves her family and father. So this fellow is playing on that sentiment. If you surrender to me, surrender by Gandharva marriage, let us enjoy. Otherwise, I'll destroy your family and your father. That is what he said. Iti evam abhidhaya, saying like this.
Garudat avatirya sabye pano guhitva tam sabhayam salajyam vepamana shayayam anayat.
Okay, just pause Srinivas. Now this description also close to Ramayana, like, you know, beautiful wordings are used here. You see, iti bhasmasat karishyami, no chet na te pitaram sanvayam bhasmasat karishyami, threatening that iti evam abhidhaya, having said evam uktva garudat avatirya, he got down from his so-called garuda vahana, which is wooden in nature. Savye pano vamahastena, savye pano means vamahastena gruhitva, he caught her with his left hand. Tam, that girl, tam, you know, sate,
yeah.
Tam, the her, what kind of, the, see the description is, sabhayam, highly, what do you call, afraid, salajam, who was very shy, vepamanam, she was also, what do you call, shaking,
shivering.
She started shivering. She was a very shy lady with fear, and vepamanam shayam anayat. He took her, dragged her to the bed to enjoy. Yeah, here we go. Tatascha.
Ratri shesham yavad.
Yavad vatsayana.
Nishevya pratyushe svagruham.
Alakshito jagama tatasya, then he dragged her to the bed, ratri sesham, till the last, hora of the night. Ratri sesham means the whole night is inverse. Ratri sesham yavat, till the night was there, vatsayana ukta vidhina. So at least one consolation the writer is giving to character, in the character of this Kaulika, that Kaulika did whatever he did as per Shastra, Kama Shastra. Vasayana Ukta Vidina Nishevya, having enjoyed her company as per the Vatsayana's Kama Shastra, Pratyushe, early in the morning, Swagruham Alakshitaha, without being seen. Alakshitaha Adrushtaha. Early morning, without anybody noticing him, Jagama, he left the place. Now, this is what this Kaulika started doing. For some days it went on. That is what the next sentence is.
Evam tasya tam nityam sevamanasya kalu
yati. See this sentence. Evam, in this way, tasya Kaulikasya, Tam Rajakumarim Nityam Anudinam Pratyaham Sevamanasya, while enjoying. Sevamana here is not serving, enjoying. While he was enjoying the princess like this, Kalaha Yati. His time was going every day like this. Every night he used to come with his vehicle, drop on the 7th floor, enjoy the princess, and early morning he escaped. Atha
kadachit kanchuki
kanchukinaha
kanchukinaha tasya adharoshta pravala khandanam drushtva mitaha prochuru aho pashyatasya rajakanyayaha purushoga muktaya iva shariravayava vibhavyante.
Okay, So every day this fellow was coming, posing himself as Vishnu and then enjoying and leaving. Atha then, kadachit one day, avyaya, these both are avyayas in verse. Atha, kadachit, kanchukinaha, kanchuki, kanchukinau, kanchukinaha. The chamberlains, the in-charge people in the antapura, kanchukinaha, tasyaha, visarga sandhi, Srinivas, kanchukinaha, tasyaha, rajakumariyaha, adhara, osta, pravala, khandhanam, drushtva. Seeing her lower lip, which was like pravala khanda, which was like the coral, you know, tender coral, pravala, coral like, cuts on the lower lip. She one day came before the security people. They just had a glance and they found that all marks which are there possible only in sex. Adhara, osta pravala khandanam, that cutting, lip cutting, that her tender lip being, you know, cut. Drushtva, mitaha means parasparam. They can't speak out, huh? So the security people, chamberlains, kanchukinaha, mitaha parasparam procho, they spoke among themselves. Oho, pashyata, look, asyaha, this, rajakanyayaha, rajakumariyaha, purusha upabhuktayaha iva, purushena upabhuktayaha, sevitayaha iva, as if enjoyed by, look at this princess, our princess, she has all the marks as if she has been enjoyed by somebody. Purusha upabhuktayaha iva sharira avayavaha. All her body, not only the hair, some more marks were seen on her body. Sharira avayavaha vibhavyante lakshyante are seen. Look at her lower lip and many other parts, I mean whatever visible parts are there in the head mainly, which are seen to have the marks enjoyed by a man. How is this possible? We are guarding so. Then they can't understand, in spite of our tight security, how is one fellow coming and doing this? Tat katamayam. Yeah, that is what?
Yasmin.
Surakshite api. Asmin. Asmin.
Asmin. What is that?
Surakshite api asmin gruhe.
Gruhe.
Yeah. So they don't, they fail to understand tat katam, kama, then how come ayam surakshite api asmin gruhe, this house, this palace is so surakshita, in such a well guarded palace, evam vidaha vyavaharaha, this kind of activity is going on. So naturally they fail to understand how is this happening when it is highly protected. Tad, therefore, Ragne Nivedayamaha, let us inform this to the king. Ragne Chaturthi, Raja Rajano Rajanaha, Rajanam Rajano Ragnaha, Ragna Rajabhyam Rajabhihi, Ragne Chaturthi, Nivedanartham Chaturthi, Tadarte Chaturthi, Ragne Nivedayamaha Suchayamaha, let us go and inform to the king, otherwise we will be blamed. Isn't it? What are you doing as being in the security? So they go. Evam nishchitya.
Nishchitya sarve samepya rajanam prochuru. He deva vayam na vidmaha param surakshitevi sanyantapure kaschit pravishati. Taddevaha pramanam.
Taddevaha pramanam. Wonderful reporting, famous. See, they did not tell all these things. How beautiful the reporting of this chamberlain is, very aptly, very indicative. So they went, evam nishchitya, having decided like this, as the previous line, ragne nivedayamaha evam nishchitya, sarve kanchukinaha, all the chamberlains, sametya. See, one fellow, here you should see this direction, Srinivas. One fellow did not come to tell that. All of them together came, because it's a very confidential and reputational issue. If one fellow comes, he will be banged by the king. So all came, sarve sametya, sammilya, Rajanam prochuhu, they told the king, hey Deva, vayam na vidmaha. Look at the opening sentence. Sir, O king, we don't know what this is happening. Firstly, their defensive sentence, you try to understand. Hey Deva, vayam na vidmaha. We don't know. This is defensive. They are taking defense in that dialogue and then say, Param, but surakshite api kanyantapuri. Even though the Kanya's Antapura harem is well protected, there is somebody coming. No other information is given. Kaschit pravishati, somebody is entering. We don't know. In spite of our tight security, somebody is entering. All the other things are not told. Wonderful reporting. But you are Devaha means Raja Pramanam. You only, now you are the Pramanam, you have to take the action. Pramanam means here not our Vaidika, that Vedanta Pramanam. That means now you take the decision. Now it's up to you what to do. So you are Pramanam, that is what.
Tachrutva Raja Ativa Vyakula
Vyakulita Chitto Vyachintayat
Putri Tijata Mahati Hachinta Kasmai Pradeyeti Mahanvitarkaha Datta Sukham Praksyati Manaveti Kanya Pitrutvam Khalulama Kashtam.
Then the, after all, though he is a king, he is also a father. So we come to know through this poem that every father of a young girl in India, let us put that, this has been our mentality, he is always intense regarding his daughter when she comes of marriageable age. Now that is what is expressed. Tat Shrutva, listening to that complaint of the chamberlain, Raja Ativa Vyakulita Chittaha, he was highly disturbed in mind, Srinivas. Ativa Vyakulita Chittaha Vyachintaya, then he thought like this. Putriti Jata, there is a Patantara, Srinivas. Jateti Kanya. Putriti Jata, these two words are Patantara. Jateti Kanya Mahatihi Chinta. That a girl is born, Mahati Chinta, it's a great worry for the parents. That a girl is born in a family, along with the birth of a girl, this is our mentality, that Mahati Chinta Api Jata Bhavati. So that is what, Putri Iti Jata, Jati Iti Kanya, both are same, Mahati Iha Chinta. There is a great worry, once a daughter is born. See, if this is the case with a king, imagine what about an ordinary citizen like us. Kasmai pradeyeti, this is the worry of the parents. Kasmai varaya, kasmai purushaya, pradeya, yat pranum. Pradeya means datavya iti. So, daughter is born, along with the daughter, worry also has come. Then the next step is says, kasmai. When she comes of marriageable age, kasmai varaya pradeya datavya. To which vara should she be given? That's another big question. Kasmai, understood is varaya pradeya datavya. To which groom should she be offered? That is also a big question. Mahan vitarkaha. There is a great discussion or what do you call? Indecision, vitarkaha, guesswork, whom should she be given? Then datta, supposing given, then some decision is taken, they have thought of giving the girl to somebody, datta, given, sukam prapsyati vana veti chinta, you have to take, datta, given, datta means tanta, da datta, kasmai chit varaya datta, sukam prapsyati vanaveti chinta. Chinta is understood. Okay, then decided and then given to some vara. Will she be happy or not? That is the worry of the parents. Before marriage, whom should we give? After marriage, will she be happy or not? Datta, I am missing there. Sukam prapsyati va na va. Prapsyati, sukam lapsyate na va iti chinta. That is understood, chinta bhavati. Therefore he says, kanya pitrutvam, the fatherhood of a girl. Pitrutvam, the fatherhood of a girl, khalu indeed nama, very customary, very difficult. So the father's position indeed in India, bracket within bracket, is very difficult. Once he has a daughter who is of marriageable age, whom should I give? If given, will she be happy or not? No, this is the always worry with the parent. Next, one more.
Nartiyascha nariyascha sadruk prabhavah Kulyani kulani kulani tasaham Toyaischa doshaischa nipatayanti Nartiyohi kulani kulani nariyah.
This is not there in some books, Srinivas. In the standard books I did not find, but some books are giving. Kale has not taken this. But there is some similarity here shown between Nadi and Nari. If you know, there was a wonderful cinema, Ram Teri Ganga Maili Ho Gayi. Wonderful film in Hindi made by Raj Kapoor's film. One of the last, almost after that he made Bobby cinema, Ram Teri Ganga Maili Ho Gayi. There is a wonderful, a similar dialogue. When I was reading, it struck me. He says, Nadi aur Nari, rahe auron ke kalank dhoti dhoti. There's a song, Nadi aur Nari rahe auron ke kalank dhoti dhoti. So a river washes the sins of others, a woman also washes the sins of others. You see now, Panchatantra also same thing, Nadi Nari. Nadi, the rivers spoil the kula, the banks, and a woman, if not very self-controlled, will spoil the kula of her family, kulas. He is playing on the word kula on one side with the nadi, kula on the other side with the woman. That is what we will see. Nadyascha, you know, nadi nadyau, nadyaha. Nari naryau naryaha. Very surprising, both are ikarantas, nadyaha naryascha, sadruk prabhavah, samana prabhavah. Women, rivers and women have the same effect. Both resemble, otherwise have resemblance, a common resemblance. What is that resemblance? And also effect. Tulyani kulani kulani tasam. Nadinam kulani tulyani. The banks of the rivers are similar. Narinam kulani tulyani. Women's families are similar. That is what the second line. The banks, river banks and women's families are same. Kulani. They are talking now. That is the comparison here. Nadinam kulani, narinam kulani. Etayoho dvayoho tatra tolanamasti. Toyaischa doshaischa. How they are comparable? He says, nadyaha toyaihi, with their waters. Toyam. Patram pushpam palam toyam. Toyena toyabhyam toyaihi. Nadyaha toyaihi cha. Nariyaha doshaihi cha. Rivers with their waters, women with their mistakes, dosha. Nipatayanti, they both destroy the respective kula and kula. Toyaihi nadyaha kulani nipatayanti nashayanti. Doshaihi nariyaha kulani nashayanti. Although this has no connection with the earlier shloka said that fathers are at worry when the girl is of marriageable age. And having said that, this is a little deviation, that is why some people have not taken. So what, since it is given, we study. So you understand this? Nadyaha toyaischa kulani nipatayanti nashayanti naryaha kim kurvanti doshaihi kulani nashayanti vinashayanti patayanti nipatayanti nadyohi kulani naryaha. That is what it is. Nadyaha kulani toyaihi nipatayanti naryaha kulani doshaihi nipatayanti. So that is what is. Now one may ask, how do rivers spoil the kula? Means with adhika jala prabhavena. If there is lot of pressure in the water, then the banks will be spoiled. Similarly, if there is lot of ambition in the women to enjoy, then they will spoil their family. That is what is the comparison. You can say, dosha means here, vyavicharadi doshaihi. Nariyaha kulani nashayanti nipatayanti, they drift. Yeah, one more sloka is there.
Janani manoharati jatavati parivardhate sahasucha sukrudam parasat krutapi kurute maninam duratikraha duhitaro vipadaha.
This is a poem also which speaks about daughters. When born, what are the sentiments that are there in our families? Jananim, janani manaha harati jatavati. When a girl is born, she, what happens? She affects the mind of her mother. Putri jatavati, janani manaha harati. She impacts the mind of the mother. Now this is we have to understand these slokas keeping that background, Panchatantra background. Our society has evolved a lot now. Ladki ko padao, ladki ko bachao, the Prime Minister slogan which is there. And there are so many areas where women are doing fine, but in those days, remote days. So janani manaha jatavati putri harati. Parivardhate saha shucha sahrudam. And when she is parivardhate, when she is growing, as the girl grows in our Indian families, saha shucha saha dukkena saha sahrudam. Sahrudam means swabhandavanam. Their worry also grows. As she grows, the worry of her relatives also grows. Parivardhate is common. Saha shucha saha dukkena saha sukhrudam svabhandavanam shokam api parivardhati chinta api parivardhati parasat krutapi. Supposing parasat krutapi means anyasmai dattapi. Parasat means given, daughter is given to somebody. Now this is what Kalidas also said. Some people, feminists, don't agree. Arthohi kanya parakiya eva. This is typical Indian mind, mind has changed now. Arthaha hi kanya, kanyarthaha, parakiya eva. What Kalidasa says, a girl is like the artha, money of somebody else with you. She is like a deposit, he uses the word. Artho hi kanya parakiya eva, tamadhya sampreshya parigrahituhu. Jato mamayam vishada prakamam antaratma pratyarpita nyasa eva. Nyasa means deposit. A girl is with the parents like a deposit. When the deposit matures, it has to be handed over to the depositor. Now who the depositor is a big question. That is what Kalyasa said. Arthohi kanya parakiya eva. That is what. Similarly, parasat krutapi anyasmai samarpitapi. Kurute malinam, there is a possibility of that she may bring bad name to the family. Duratikrama duhitaro vipadaha. This poem has a kind of criticism of women. duratikramaha duhitaraha vipadaha. That means it is difficult to separate daughters from misery. Duhitaraha, daughters, vipadaha, vipadaha, duratikrama. That means daughters are vipadas. Vipada means miseries, which are duratikrama, very difficult to be crossover. A daughter is like a problem for the Indian father, like that, something like that said it is. Can we stop here?
Yeah.
Shubham Bhuya.